You got the big wedding. Well, how big was your wedding? Have you had any weddings?
You know what? I had the most beautiful romantic wedding. I married this really, I'm not married anymore, I'm divorced now. But I had a spectacular fairy tale wedding with a horse-drawn carriage. I got married in New York in a castle. In Tarrytown,
That's big.
It was lovely in this really beautiful old steeple church. I had an amazing gown. It was just amazing and beautiful. I would wish that for my daughter.
Would you want another big wedding?
No.
Why?
I'm too old for that. I think marriage is something that you do when you really want to raise a family and you want them to have that unity and that comfort. But when you get older and it's like a second or a third marriage and your children are grown, I think it's kind of superfluous, you know. I think the spiritual bond is much more sacred and deeper at that point. I really know who I am as a human being. You know, I don't need all the bells and whistles anymore.
Now, the big wedding did need a lot of bells and whistles. It got some great bells and whistles, right, with some great actors, Susan Sarandon, and all those. Of all of them, did you learn anything? I mean, you've been in the industry a while. You know exactly what to do, but did you learn anything?
I did. From Diane Keaton, I learned really how to to really create your own space, even in a large cast, and when you're, like, her moments before, like, you know, right before she gets on camera, she's always thinking as the character, dialoguing as the character, and so when she comes on to the camera, she's already bringing a life with her, you know, and that was something that I still stole from her.
Okay, all right.
Sorry. Also, she uses headphones a lot and music to kind of influence her moods, which is another thing I kind of borrowed. Okay.
Okay, well then what do you listen to, like, to get, you know, to have a fun moment?
Oh, me?
Yeah.
I love alternative music, believe it or not.
Wow.
Yeah.
Like who?
I love all those crazy new bands, like, now I can't think of one of them. I'm really into Jack White.
Okay.
I love his new solo album. All those, like, they have all these weird names now. I don't know what the name of any of the bands are.
Check out your playlist. Okay. Real quick question on, you know, the National Hispanic Media Coalition. Why are organizations like this so important?
Yeah,
Someone doesn't fight for our image and our right to be represented in a positive way, then who's going to fight for us? We have to do that for ourselves. Nobody's going to champion us, you know? So we have to have these kind of organizations and to honor positive images on screen, on television, and news anchors, you know, a part of the fabric of America, you know, and it's so important.
I have a question. You know, obviously everybody's thinking of Argo, and some of people are a little peeved that Ben Affleck took a Latino role. What's your viewpoint?
You know what? Sometimes that's what it takes to make a film and to tell a story, you know. It's as long as it's fair, you know. I've played non-Latinos. I've played Italian women. I've played Jewish women. We're actors, you know. I think as long as you're putting a story out and you're truthful to it, then, you know, whatever it takes to get a job done sometimes.